Vultures in general have a bad reputation thanks to their carrion-eating lifestyle, and bearded vultures are no exception, with a label of lamb killer causing their ultimate demise in the Alps. It's unfortunate that many people fail to see the wonderful service these birds provide. Vultures consume the corpses that, if left festering, could cause unimaginable disease outbreak. And in Asia, Africa, and Southern Europe, bearded vultures act as the tail end of this natural cleanup crew. Why? A bearded vulture's diet consists almost entirely of bones. That's pretty metal. After the other scavengers have cleaned the fleshy bits of carcasses, bearded vultures swoop in on wingspans of more than 8.5 feet to swallow small bones whole and grab larger bones, which will then be dropped from heights of more than 300 feet until they break to consumable sizes. Yeah, these birds are metal as f- Bearded vultures get their name from the dangly beard hanging below their beak. Younger bearded vultures, without adult plumage, may have a less conspicuous beard, but as they age, the beard becomes more prominent. Adult bearded vultures also appear in varying shades of rusty red. Unlike the pink feathers of flamingos obtained through diet, a bearded vulture's red color is actually obtained from the surrounding environment. Adults will bathe in pools rich in iron oxide, which in turn stains their white feathers red. Why the birds do this is still a mystery, though some hypotheses include disease prevention, as well as display of strength. In general, female bearded vultures are slightly larger than males, and a pair or trio of bearded vultures will fiercely defend their 100 square mile or larger territory. These birds live in mountainous areas, usually more than 2,000 feet above sea level. They live on the edges of the earth, usually sticking to cliffs overlooking fields where prey items may be found. Bearded vultures prefer the bones of small to mid-size ungulates, but they will also take smaller mammals and even reptiles if the need arises. For these birds, the best time for finding food is in winter. Think about it. Winter is usually the most difficult season for animals to endure, which means bearded vultures tend to have more food during this time. Because of this, bearded vultures time their reproduction with this increase in food supply. Bearded vultures are typically considered monogamous, but trios of two males and one female have been documented living together as well. Each parent takes part in building the nest and caring for the young. Typically, more than one egg is laid, but only one chick will survive, with the second egg laid as insurance against a premature death of the first egg. The eggs are incubated for about 2 months, and the surviving young will leave the nest at about 4 months of age. It's during this time that bearded vultures are most vulnerable. Not only can poor weather conditions take the lives of the developing birds, predators such as ravens, eagles, or other vultures may consume them as well. If they can manage past this perilous stage of life, and they can avoid the hazards imposed on them both by humans and the natural elements, adult bearded vultures may live long lives at the top of the food chain. For more facts on bearded vultures, check out the links in the description. Give a thumbs up for birds, and thank you for watching Animal Fact Files.